Halloween, a time of costumes, candy, and horror. Movies, that is. For many decades, Hollywood has delighted us with spooky stories of ghosts and goblins, monsters and madmen, and things that go bump in the night. Oftentimes, Hollywood depend on great soundtracks and songs to create their thrills and chills in these movies. That list has been done to death, and we're not going to focus on that. Instead, we're going to talk about the artists who have decided to write songs about these very classic movies. I'm Chris from Redbeard Videos, and today we're counting down the top 5 songs inspired by horror movies. For this list, we're looking at songs that have lyrics and or music that either reference, are about, or are fully inspired by the classic horror movies we all love and are scared by. And before we hit that list though, just a reminder, please comment, like, and subscribe, and hit up our socials at VideosBeard on Twitter and RedBeardVideos on Facebook. So here's a song that actually sounds like a horror movie, and clocking in at nearly 7 minutes, it plays as a mini horror musical. With hectic and punishing drums, constant tempo shifts, a grumbling, angry vocalist throughout, and a gothic orchestral backing track of vocals, cellos, and voices, with the occasional singular melodic voice soaring through, without even knowing the lyrics, the gothic metalers Dimmu Borgir conjure the good versus evil push and pull of someone who is in constant peril, and given the fact that this song is based on one of the most horrifying villains in movie history, a quick pulse and a sense of dread is certainly what you're going for. Based on the Hellraiser movies, Hybrid Stigmata is an exercise of audio endurance that certainly creates an image of what I think it'd be like to encounter Pinhead and his Cenobites. How long do you think you can stay in this audio chamber Dimmu Borgir have created?
Now you must come with us, taste our pleasures.
From the 2011 release The Hunter, the normally bombastic and technical Atlanta-based Mastodon shows an ability to tell a story with very few words. The song, based on the creature from the Black Lagoon, is slight on actual lyrics with only 2 short verses and a repetitive refrain of "The creature lives." Musically, the song is very subdued with a Moog intro into a melodic bass riff and a very catchy vocal line that is almost something you can get a crowd to sing along to, which may have been the point. When asked during a Rolling Stone interview, Brand Daler, drummer and vocalist, said, "We never had a real sing-along song before. When I wrote it in my head, I remember driving around thinking about that fact." A very deep and meaningful tune that certainly makes me think of the dreadful creature emerging from the Black Lagoon, but certainly has a social message too about judging a book by its cover. But that's not why we're here today, so we'll just move on. This song, whew. Not a whole lot to be said here. I know at the top of the video we said that we weren't going to pick songs that were directly from movies, but more songs that were about movies or inspired by movies, but this one's a little different in my opinion. First off, it's only playing the theme of Rosemary's Baby, like the little lullaby theme, and not making the entire song a cover of that theme. Secondly, Mike Patton, the main thrust of Fantomas, incorporates lines from the movie as lyrics to the song to make it a new thing. And thirdly, how can you deny this song? I mean, wow, what a fucking killer tune. Taken from the highly acclaimed Director's Cut album, Patton's performance on this song and this whole project is one for the ages. Haunting, heavy, and just perfect for any horror fan.
What have you done to it? What have you done to its eyes?
First things first, I've loved the song Eyes Without a Face since I was a kid. However, I didn't know then what this song was about or just exactly how twisted the bass subject was. Based on a French horror film that is all in French but basically means Eyes Without a Face, I think it's Les Yeux Sans Visage. No, I'm not even going to try. Again, in the last video you saw my American ignorance and here it is again. It's French for Eyes Without a Face. Which basically is the story of a gifted plastic surgeon who gets into a car crash and as a result horribly disfigures his beautiful daughter. The doctor snaps, finds several young women to steal their facial features, and grafts them onto his daughter. I won't expand on it any further, but this movie would be way more gruesome if it wasn't made in 1960 because it was gruesome enough back in 1960. Lyrically, Billy Idol tells the story of loneliness and isolation, which surely is consistent with the premise of this movie. He even uses the French title of the movie, hauntingly sung by Perry Lister, as a musical counterpoint to his Eyes Without a Face refrain. The middle section with guitar virtuoso Steve Stevens wailing away on guitar accounts for the peril and angst that goes on in this story, and the award-winning video supports the song in a very effective way. And that about brings us to our number one. Just a reminder, before we get to that number one, please like this video or dislike this video and tell me why below. Subscribe to this channel and hit up our socials at @videosbeard on Twitter or @redbeardvideos on Facebook. Before we get to our number one video, here's our honorable mentions.
Only a woman can break his spell. You're in heart, who will offer herself?
Comes the woman with cocoa but the skin once. Once again they call me Buffalo Bill. Buffalo Bill, Buffalo Bill. Skin him up, him him, sew him up in those kilts. Up in those kilts.
Okay, so you can see that this was labeled 1A because, well, Halloween's a weird time of year. It's spooky, and I figured what's spookier than adding an extra song? It's a ghost track, a paranormal activity track, if you will. So we have a dual number one for this one because I couldn't decide about these two songs, honestly. With that being said, Iced Earth, Dracula is 1A. This song is so friggin' epic in every way. Musically, it kicks off with a haunting acoustic guitar lead intro with a few somber verses, but then it immediately kicks into high gear with Matt Barlow's soaring voice awakening the cries of pain that Dracula is truly about, lost love. Amongst a collection of horror-inspired tunes from Iced Earth's 2001 horror show, Iced Earth's Dracula, hands down, is the most accurate depiction of the movie it's trying to emulate. Taking its inspiration and a direct quote from 1992's Bram Stoker's Dracula, when listening to this tune, you can truly feel the angst and anger of a man who cannot die, but desperately wants to so he can be with his love, who was so tragically taken from him. So since he cannot die, everyone else will.
You think you can destroy me with your eyes?
We all know the general story of Dracula, and if you listen to this song, you'll hear it and you'll feel it too. So I know, this is probably an upset win for a lot of you watching. Serving as the theme song for the third installment of the Nightmare on Elm Street series, Dream Warriors was a hit for the 80s metal band Dokken, and frankly, one of my very favorite songs of all time. So, was this a biased pick? Absolutely, 100%. But with that, it's also a fantastic song and deserves recognition. Heavy for its genre, great melody lines, and tremendous harmonies, plus that guitar solo by George Lynch is an all-timer. The video was very cool for the time as well, with George Lynch breaking through a wall during his solo to fight Freddy Krueger and try and save the girl. Dream Warriors was definitely my favorite movie of this series as a kid, and this song always reminds me of that, so that's why it ends up here. Oh, and the song lyrically does an excellent job of describing what a continuous bout with Freddy would look like if we were all Dream Warriors, so there's that as well. And that's it. If you happen to disagree with my 100% biased 1B pick, you can let me know several ways. First off, you can like this video or dislike this video. You can subscribe so you can just follow the rest of my biased picks. Or you can leave a comment below and tell me what you think the list should be. Either you liked my list, or you wanted to add to it, or you would move some around. Or you can hit me up on my socials, @VideosBeard on Twitter or RedBeardVideos on Facebook. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and we will catch you next time. See ya.